Indonesia, located in the heart of the Pacific Ring of Fire, is a nation made up of thousands of islands, surrounded by stunning landscapes and crystal-clear waters. Yet, beneath this natural beauty lies one of the most dangerous geological systems on Earth. The region's history is marked by a series of devastating seismic events, the most iconic being the earthquake, followed by a tsunami in 2004, which shocked the world and resulted in the loss of hundreds of thousands of lives. That event drew the attention of the international scientific community to the Sunda Fault, one of the largest and most active subduction zones on the planet. Beneath the seemingly calm waters of the Indian Ocean lies the dreaded Sunda Megathrust Fault, a collision line between tectonic plates that stretches for over 3,100 miles, 5,000 kilometers, from the Andaman Archipelago to southeastern Indonesia. This structure behaves like a geological spring, storing tension over decades, until it suddenly releases massive energy in a catastrophic event. Unlike other faults that cause only lateral movement, Sunda can generate vertical displacements of the ocean floor, producing tsunamis with terrifying speed and force. The 9.1 magnitude earthquake in 2004 is just one example of what this fault is capable of. After the rupture, massive waves formed and swept across the ocean, devastating entire communities and leaving a trail of destruction. Alarmingly, experts believe the Sunda Fault still holds enough energy to generate even more intense future events. Various studies indicate that some segments of the fault have remained locked for centuries, such as the Mentawai region, significantly increasing the risk of new high-magnitude earthquakes. Sumatra and Java, two of Indonesia's most populous islands, lie directly in the danger zone. With millions living near the coast, the time window for response in the event of an earthquake and tsunami would be extremely short. Cities like Padang would have less than 30 minutes to evacuate, highlighting the urgent need for preparedness and public awareness. Furthermore, many buildings in these areas were not designed to withstand strong tremors, increasing the risk of structural collapse and large-scale loss of life. The impacts of a major seismic event go far beyond physical destruction. Indonesia's economy, one of the strongest in Southeast Asia, would also be severely affected. Ports, highways, industrial centers, and factories would be damaged, halting the supply chain and disrupting global trade. In addition, there's the danger of secondary disasters, such as landslides and industrial accidents, including chemical and fuel leaks, which would further worsen the post-disaster scenario. Despite the constant threat, there have been significant advances. Since the 2004 tsunami, Indonesia has heavily invested in monitoring technology and early warning systems. Underwater sensors, seismic stations, and satellite data help track every movement of the tectonic plates. These measures have already saved lives, but the biggest challenge remains ensuring that all communities, including the most remote, are ready to act quickly when the inevitable occurs. As monitoring systems evolve, scientists continue to analyze subtle signs from the Sunda Fault. Using GPS data, seafloor sensors, and advanced computational models, they can map with some precision the areas where tension is most concentrated. This work is vital for identifying critical points and implementing mitigation strategies. However, even with all this technology, predicting the exact moment of the next rupture is still impossible. Nature remains unpredictable, and that uncertainty makes preparation even more essential. Multiple simulations conducted by experts show that if several parts of the Sunda Fault were to rupture simultaneously, the resulting earthquake could exceed a magnitude of 9 with global repercussions. Tsunamis triggered by events of this scale do not respect borders. Waves can strike neighboring countries and even reach distant continents, impacting unsuspecting populations and damaging fragile ecosystems. Thus, monitoring the fault is not just Indonesia's concern, it is a matter of global importance. Indonesia's coastal ecosystems are under constant threat. Coral reefs, which act as natural wave barriers, are frequently destroyed by tsunamis, affecting not only marine biodiversity, but also the livelihoods of fishing communities. Mangrove forests, equally vital for coastal protection, take years to regenerate after a major impact. The loss of these ecosystems further weakens natural defenses against disasters, making these regions even more vulnerable to future events. Rebuilding after a major earthquake is a long and difficult process. Following the 2004 disaster, Indonesia received aid from dozens of countries and international organizations. Temporary shelters were built, food was distributed, and new infrastructure was installed. Yet many survivors struggled to resume their lives. The loss of loved ones, homes, and livelihoods left deep scars in the population. This collective trauma illustrates how the consequences of natural disasters go far beyond material damage. Despite the challenges, Indonesian communities have shown remarkable resilience. Periodic drills are held in schools, neighborhoods, and villages to teach people how to respond to earthquakes and tsunami alerts. Children learn from an early age to seek higher ground and stay calm. These simple exercises make a huge difference when disaster strikes. The knowledge shared can mean the difference between life and loss. It is an effective strategy that saves lives and strengthens the community spirit. International cooperation is also crucial in this battle against natural disasters. Researchers from around the world share real-time data, exchange experiences, and help develop new detection technologies. This joint effort allows a better understanding of the Sunda Fault's behavior and leads to increasingly effective solutions to reduce its impact. Even though earthquakes cannot be prevented, science offers tools to face them with more readiness and less suffering. Over the years, the seismic silence in certain parts of the Sunda Fault has raised concern, particularly off the coast of Java, where the absence of significant tremors does not signify safety, but rather a possible buildup of energy ready to be unleashed. This kind of geological silence is compared to a sleeping volcano that, although quiet, holds immense power. Scientists know that the time between events does not reduce the risk. It only increases the potential for destruction when the rupture eventually happens. Cities like Jakarta and Surabaya, which house millions of people, are closely watched by authorities and experts. These urban centers not only contain old and fragile buildings, but also deal with chronic infrastructure issues, such as flooding and unstable ground. A powerful earthquake in these areas could trigger a cascade of collapses in hospitals, schools, and public buildings, while paralyzing essential services. The lack of efficient evacuation routes makes mobility a major obstacle in critical moments. Earthquake simulation models are valuable tools used by experts to forecast possible scenarios. These studies suggest that depending on how much of the fault ruptures, an earthquake could generate tsunamis with waves over 33 feet, 10 meters high, reaching the coastlines in just minutes. This would leave very little time for evacuation, especially in densely populated coastal areas. Public awareness and government commitment will be key to ensuring that when the next major event occurs, we are ready to respond with efficiency and solidarity. The road is long, but every step matters. If you found this content important, give this video a thumbs up and share it with someone interested in science, geology, or simply curious about the mysteries of our planet. Subscribe to the channel for more stories like this, always presented in a clear and accessible way. Turn on the notification bell so you never miss an update, and leave your suggestions for future topics in the comments. Together, we can transform knowledge into a powerful tool to save lives and build a safer future. See you in the next video.